Hello learners, welcome back to my channel Swadhas Physics. Today we will see the Fourier transform of the derivatives. Now let us start the Fourier transform of the derivatives. Before going to start the Fourier transform of the derivative, so why we are studying this Fourier transform of the derivatives particularly? What is the need to calculate the derivatives of the Fourier transform? This Fourier transform, it can be used to convert the differential equation into an algebraic equation. Okay, this solution of the original equation, it can be obtained by taking the inverse transform of the solution of that simpler equation. Okay, so for that purpose, we should know how to calculate the Fourier transform of the derivative. Let us consider, suppose we have a function f of x. Okay, for that function, if I want to write the Fourier transform of this function f of x, for that we can write f of k, here I am writing this f of k, this is equal to 1 by root over 2 pi, this is the formula, integration over minus infinite to plus infinite f of x into exponential of this function, that is exponential iota k, again this x variable, iota kx into, since this is f of x inside this integration, so I will write this will be dx. Clear? This is the representation of the Fourier transform in general. Okay, in general, we can write the Fourier transform in this way. We have already discussed about this in the first lecture. Suppose this is equation 1. Now, if I take the first derivative, if I take the first derivative of this function, then I can write this as df of x divided by dx. This is the first derivative of the function. Now, if I want to calculate the Fourier transform of this function, then in place of f of x, simply I have to write df divided by dx, because I want to calculate, if I consider this total df by dx as a total function, then if I want to calculate the Fourier transform of this function, then simply in place of f of x, I will write d by dx of f of x. So let me write, suppose the first derivative of the function, that is f1 of k, that will be equal to, you will write here, this is the first order derivative. Okay, you will write in your own language. So this will be f1 of k will be equal to 1 by root over of 2 pi. This is the first order derivative. First order derivative, that is df of x divided by dx. Fourier transform, here I am writing f1 of k equal to 1 by root over 2 pi, integration over minus infinite to plus infinite, in place of f of x, we will write our function df of x divided by dx into exponential iota kx into dx. Okay, this is suppose equation 2. Now we will solve this equation. So then, let us see what will happen. Now, we will focus on this. This is equal to 1 by root over 2 pi. Again, here you can see that this is df of x divided by dx is one function, and this is your exponential I k x is another function. So, we can solve this by integration by parts we are going to apply here. This is suppose u, here we will consider this exponential I k x as u, and this df of x divided by dx as my v. So that if I'll apply the integration by part, I think you can remember the formula, that is, if we want to integrate, let me change the color. If I want to integrate, the integration over, suppose this is u into v dx, then for this u and v, these are the two functions. You can remember the formula, that is the I-late formula. Okay, but here we'll consider this exponential as suppose u, and this df by dx, this df by dx as my v function. Okay, u and v both are the function of x, so that this will be equal to, if I apply the integration by parts, then this will be u into v into dx minus integration over bracket strat dou u by dou x, this is the partial derivative with respect to x, integration over v dx whole into dx. There are two ds, you can see. This is one ds for first integration and another ds is for the second integration. Always try to remember that if you have any limiting value, just try to put that limit at the end of the result. Okay, at the first you have to calculate v dx integration. That after solving this, at last you have to apply this integration with its limit. Okay, now if I'll apply this formula here, let me write the equation 2 again. This will be equal to f1k, this is f1, wait for a minute, this will be f1 of k equal to f1 of k, this will be equal to 1 by root over 2 pi will remain as it is. This is 1 by root over of 2 pi. Here I have to integrate u integration v dx. U is here exponential I k, so let me write exponential iota kx into v dx means df by dx. Here I am writing this is df by dx into dx. Again minus, for this second term I have to write integration over dou u by dou x, means here exponential I k x derivative is iota k into exponential iota k x into integration over here v dx. So this will be, here I am directly writing integration over v is df divided by dx into dx, again the whole bracket dx. Okay, and we have to put the limit, that is from minus infinite to plus infinite. This will be minus infinite to plus infinite. Okay, now this ds ds get cancelled, so the integration over df will be f. So this is equal to 1 by root over 2 pi, this exponential iota kx, exponential iota kx. So this will be exponential I kx into this will be f of x. Okay, we have to now integrate this ds ds get cancelled, so integration over df will be f of x, and the integration value will range from minus infinite to plus infinite. So this will be plus infinite. Again this will be minus, let me close this bracket first, I'll multiply this 1 by root over 2 pi here. So this will be minus 1 by root over 2 pi, 1 by, so this will be 1 by root over 2 pi, okay, into this I k will be taken common. So this will be I k divided by root over 2 pi. Here we have multiplied this 1 by root over 2 pi in the second term. So this will be I k divided by root over 2 pi into the integration over minus infinite to plus infinite integration over. So this will be integration over minus infinite to plus infinite into exponential I k x into this will be f of x into dx, because also here this dx dx also get cancelled. So the integration of df, since this is f is a function of x, we can write the integration of df will be f of x, and here this dx will come here, that is dx. Since here you can see that there are two parts of the equation, this f1 of k equal to 1 by root over 2 pi into something minus I k divided by root over 2 pi into something. Our equation is in this form. This function, the function we have considered, that is f of x, it is a well behaved function and it is a finite function. Hence if we will consider that this function will approaches to 0 when x tends to infinite. So let me write here, suppose I am considering that if the value of x tends to plus or minus infinite, then for that condition, if the function tends to 0, I am considering the function tends to zero. So in this case, we can say that if the value x tends to infinite, then since this function goes to zero, so the first term vanishes, but that value will be equal to zero. So the second part will remain, that is f1 of k, we can write this is equal to minus iota k by root over 2 pi integration over minus infinite to plus infinite exponential I k x into f of x dx. So let me write this expression here. This f1 of k equal to, here I am writing this f1 of k, f1 of k, this will be equal to minus I k divided by root over 2 pi integration over minus infinite to plus infinite this f of x into, this will be f of x into exponential iota kx into dx. Now you can check it from here, that is minus ik divided by root over 2 pi integration over exponential ikx f of x dx, right? But the equation 1 here, the equation 1, you can see this is f of k equal to 1 by root over 2 pi times integration over minus infinite to plus infinite f of x exponential ikx dx. So in this place, if I'll put f of k here, again if I'll write this is equal to minus ik terms and the rest of the term, that is 1 by root over 2 pi and integration over minus infinite to plus infinite f of x exponential ikx dx, you can see that this is f of k, this total term represent f of k. So here I can write this term as this is f of k. So finally, what we conclude is that this f1 of k, that is the first derivative, first order derivative of the function f of x, that is df by dx, the Fourier transform of the df by dx is f1 of k, which is equal to minus ik into f of k, where f of k is the Fourier transform of the f of x. Now we will see the Fourier transform of the second order derivative of f of x. Okay, so second order derivative of f of x means d square f means this is the function of x divided by dx square. So now we have to calculate the Fourier transform of this function. Similarly, if I'll consider this f2 of k, this is the Fourier transform of the second order derivative of this function f of x, this is equal to 1 by root over 2 pi. I think up to this much you can remember that formula, that is integration over minus infinite to plus infinite. We have repeated it for many more times, so just try to solve by your own. This will be the function. The function means here d square f of x divide f of x divided by dx square into exponential ikx exponential iota k into x into dx. This is our representation. Now if I'll take again the if I'll solve this by putting the integration by part, then also we can solve this. Let us consider this d square by d square f by dx square. It can be written as this is equal to, here I am writing d by dx of df by dx, I can write df by dx. Here I can also write it as d by dx of df by dx. Suppose we will consider this df by dx is suppose g of x, so that we can write this d by dx of g of x. This is the simple notation, so that since we have calculated for the first order derivative, then this will be quite simpler to calculate this function. So in place of d square by dx square f of x, I can write d by dx of g of x. Are you getting my point? This g of x is nothing but, here I am writing g of x is nothing but df by dx. Okay, this will be df divided by dx. Now if I'll put here, this will be equal to, this will be 1 by root over 2 pi times integration limit will remain same, minus infinite to plus infinite. This will be d by dx of g of x, I can write d by dx of any other function, that is g of x, which is equal to d by dx. Okay, d by dx of g of x into exponential iota kx into dx. This term is d by dx of g of x only. Okay, this exponential ikx into dx. Now here we can say that since we have considered that at x tends to plus or minus infinite, this function f of x, it goes to 0. Since this function goes to 0, we can write df by dx also here goes to 0. Df by dx also goes to 0. Is that clear? Now, if I solve in a similar way, that is while we are calculating for the first order derivative, so this will be simply, this will be equal to, here you can see that in the first order derivative, while we are calculating for the first order derivative, this will be simply minus ik into f of k. Since this is in the f of x form, simply we have to write this will be minus ik into f of k. But here, in this case, if we will solve by putting the integration by part, we will get the inside the integration, the term remain will be, that is g of x. And this g of x is nothing but df by dx. So our final answer will be like minus, or let me write the formula, total answer, sorry, let me write, the final will be minus ik divided by root over 2 pi, this will be root over 2 pi, in place of f of x, I will write g of x, so this will be integration over minus infinite to plus infinite, g of x will remain into exponential ikx into dx. Okay, now this g of x is nothing but df by dx. Let me write, so in place of g of x, here I am writing, this is my df by dx, because here we have considered that g of x is df by dx, so this will be df divided by dx. Here I am writing df by dx, so this is nothing but f1 of k. Here you can see that this f1 of k is nothing but 1 by root over 2 pi integration over d by dx of f of x into exponential ikx into dx. So here this will be nothing but minus ik, here I can write this is equal to minus ik times, this will be f1 of k, right? Or we can write this as, this will be equal to minus ik whole square f1k. Can I write like this? Because the square of minus is plus, minus 1 square is plus 1, I square will be minus 1. No, let me solve this equation so that this will be better. I'll solve this by integration by part. Here this function is u, exponential ikx is u, and this df by dx is v. So this will be equal to, here only 1 by root over 2 pi is present. So let me write, this is only 1 by root over 2 pi. I will solve this equation first. So that this will be 1 by root over 2 pi. It will remain as it is. Again this will be integration over minus infinite. I am directly writing, this is, I am putting here integration by parts. So this will be u into v dx. So u here is exponential ikx. So here I will write exponential iota kx into integration over da by dx into dx. So this will be, here I have to write, this is not df by dx. Since we are calculating for d by dx of g of x, I have to solve from this. So let me erase this part. So I have to solve this. Okay, this is my original equation. Let me check again. Yes, this is my d by dx of g of x, right? So let me solve. We know the integration by parts formula. Let me write it again. This will be integration over u v dx. This will be equal to u into integration v dx minus integration over dou u by dou x into integration v dx into dx. Now, if we'll put here, this will be equal to 1 by root over 2 pi. It will remain as it is. This is equal to 1 by root over 2 pi integration over minus infinity to infinity. Here, this exponential I k is my u and this d by dx of gx is my v. Now, u will be exponential iota kx, exponential iota kx, and this integration v dx here is integration over d by dx of g of x into dx. Okay, this integration varies from minus infinite to plus infinite. Again, this is 1 by root over 2 pi. Okay, again, this is minus integration over minus infinite to plus infinite. Dou u by dou x is here iota k exponential iota kx. Okay, again, integration over v dx. So, this will be integration over d by dx of g of x, or here I am writing simply g into dx whole into dx. Okay. Now, this bracket is already closed. Here, I can cancel this dx with the dx, and the integration over dgx will be g of x, and this g of x is nothing but df by dx. So, this will be equal to first term 1 by root over 2 pi. For the first term I am writing here, this will be exponential iota kx, and this d of g of x will be g of x integration, and dgf of x integration will be g of x, and this g of x value is df by dx. So I am directly writing it here, df by dx over the limit minus infinite to plus infinite. Okay, this is our first term. Now, for the second term, if I'll multiply this 1 by root over 2 pi here, so this will be minus iota k divided by root over 2 pi into the integration over here minus infinite to plus infinite exponential iota kx. Here also dx dx get cancelled. The integration over dg of x will be g of x. Again, the value of g of x will be df by dx. So, here I am writing df by dx whole into dx. Okay. Now, in this second term, if you can see, this second term, that is minus ik divided by root over 2 pi integration over minus infinite to plus infinite exponential ikx into df by dx into dx. This second term particular, it can be written as, here you can see in this equation 2, f1k equal to this much integration over df by dx exponential ikx into dx, and 1 by root over 2 pi is here. So here the second term is quite similar, it is exact similar to that equation, and again this is multiplied by minus ik. Here I can write, let me erase this part, so I can write here. This will be, this is our f2 of k. Here I am calculating f2 of k. So this f2 of k will be equal to, I have already told you that when the value of x tends to plus or minus infinite, then the value f of x tends to 0. So that the first order derivative, that is d by dx of f of x, this will also goes to 0. This is our condition, so that this first term goes to 0, this term goes to 0. So for the second term I can write, this is equal to minus ik divide ik into, here I am writing into 1 by root over 2 pi times द इंटीग्रेशन ओवर माइनस इन्फानाइट टू प्लस इन्फानाइट एक्सपोनेंशियल आयोटा के एक्स इंटू दिस इज डी एफ बाई डी एक्स इंटू डी एक्स. दिस टर्म इज नथिंग बट दिस टोटल टर्म इज नथिंग बट एफ ऑफ के. हियर यू कैन सी दिस टर्म इज नथिंग बट एफ ऑफ एफ वन ऑफ के सॉरी दिस इज एफ वन ऑफ के. ना इफ विल पुट द वैल्यू देन दिस विल बी इक्वल टू माइनस आई के इंटू एफ वन ऑफ के. ओके नाउ इफ आई पुट द वैल्यू ऑफ एफ वन के हियर इफ आई पुट द वैल्यू ऑफ एफ वन ऑफ के हियर देन यू नो एफ वन ऑफ के इक्वल टू माइनस आई के इंटू एफ ऑफ के. वी हैव जस्ट कैलकुलेटेड एफ वन ऑफ के दैट इज फॉर द फर्स्ट ऑर्डर डेरिवेटिव द फोरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म इक्वल टू माइनस आई के इंटू एफ ऑफ के. देन इफ आई पुट हियर दिस विल बी इक्वल टू आई कैन राइट दिस इज इक्वल टू माइनस आई के इंटू इन दिस प्लेस एफ वन ऑफ के आई कैन राइट माइनस आई के इंटू एफ ऑफ के. ओके नाउ इफ विल कंबाइन दिस टर्म दैट इज माइनस आई के इंटू माइनस आई के सो हियर वी कैन राइट दिस इज एज दो दिस एज दो दिस विल बी जस्ट अ मिनट दिस विल बी एफ टू ऑफ के विल बी इक्वल टू माइनस आई के होल स्क्वेयर दिस विल बी माइनस आयोटा के होल स्क्वेयर इंटू एफ ऑफ के. इज दिस क्लियर. नाउ वी हैव कैलकुलेटेड दैट एफ टू ऑफ के दैट इज द फोरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म ऑफ द सेकेंड ऑर्डर डेरिवेटिव. एफ ऑफ के रिप्रेजेंट्स द फोरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म ऑफ एफ ऑफ एक्स. एफ वन ऑफ के इट रिप्रेजेंट्स द फोरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म ऑफ डी एफ बाई डी एक्स एंड एफ टू ऑफ के इट इज इट विल रिप्रेजेंट द फोरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म ऑफ डी स्क्वेयर एफ बाई डी एक्स स्क्वेयर. ओके सिमिलरली इफ यू वॉन्ट टू कैलकुलेट फॉर द nth ऑर्डर डेरिवेटिव. ओके फॉर द nth ऑर्डर डेरिवेटिव दिस इज सिमिलर टू एफ एन ऑफ के इफ एल राइट दिस इज इक्वल टू माइनस आयोटा इन टू के दिस विल बी सिंस दिस इज टू हियर द पावर इज ऑल्सो टू सो दिस विल बी सिंपली पावर एन दिस इज पावर एन इन टू एफ ऑफ के. सो इन दिस वे यू कैन कैलकुलेट एनी ऑर्डर डेरिवेटिव ऑफ द फोरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म इक्वेशन. इज दैट क्लियर. दिस इज हियर आई एम राइटिंग दिस इज द फोरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म ऑफ nth ऑर्डर डेरिवेटिव. ओके दिस इज nth ऑर्डर डेरिवेटिव ऑफ एफ ऑफ एक्स nth ऑर्डर डेरिवेटिव ऑफ एफ ऑफ एक्स. सो दिस इज ऑल फॉर टुडे. इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट कैन आस्क मी इन द कमेंट सेक्शन. थैंक यू. जय जगन्नाथ.